This week, Garen and Ellie continue to rebuild the sand rail, we finish the outbuilding, and we talk with Mom and Dad about their 27th anniversary.
All right, working on the engine again.
Got all cleaned up really nice. Into the fun part, putting it back together. Thinking what I'm gonna do is build a little stand for this thing. I'd like to set it up on end. And so I got some of this scrap 2x4. I'm gonna cut this stuff up and build a quick little stand for the engine. Then I can start putting it all together. All right, engine stand is done. This is gonna be perfect to work on this thing and not have it tipping all around. And this way I don't have to pull out the head studs. They pull out extremely easy. And if I can keep them in, it's better than trying to mess with all that and breaking out a bunch of inserts. This is gonna be the nicest way to do it, I think.
Alright, so this is the last big thing we gotta paint, really, than just little green stuff. Got it all cleaned up. We decided not to do the rhino liner on this. Instead, we're using the Rust-Oleum 2x coverage. It works really good, and I think it'll look better.
Are you time-lapsing it? Oh! I'm so happy!
As you know, our hoop barn might have or may not have caved in, and we had built up an outbuilding to store all the hoop barn stuff in, because we were talking about at one point putting cans on top of the roof, like aluminum cans, cutting them out and putting them as sheets for a metal roof. But we found out that the cans can't be crushed, and a lot of cans we have were crushed. We decided against it.
These are 1 foot strips that we're gonna use as our shingles.
We just went out, bought the metal, and chucked it out there.
We decided to go here. Every two, would that be too much? And then it hits that guy there. Seems like a lot.
You could do every three. Would that work?
Like that?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's do that.
Sending Morse code messages. I say, please help, I don't want to do this.
Is the breeze nice up there?
My hair is flying back in the wind, you can clearly see.
You gotta put your elbow grease into it.
Oh, geez.
You gotta line it up perfect and just gun it, or else it doesn't work.
Success!
It's actually quite comfortable up here. I think I'll make this my new sun tanning bed.
This is scary. I'm shaking.
Yeah, only step on where the staples are. Safety first. Ben was awesome. He hopped up on that roof, and it was the first time he really ever did a roof, and he did a really nice job. He put up a lot of those sheets.
So you guys have hit the big 27 years together as a married couple.
That's a lot of years.
Which, because you've been married so doggone long, I mean, older than me, so clearly that's a long time. We just thought we'd take and ask you guys a question about your marriage.
So what are the things you guys do to just help not fight?
I just let Shelly win.
Right, Ben?
It works every time.
Every time.
If we get mad at each other, within a half hour, we both blame ourselves. We usually come back really quickly.
Yeah.
And then we usually come out with a nicer tone when we come back.
Yeah.
A more peaceful tone.
Yeah. I've noticed that with you, Dad, you'll be super nice to Mom. Or Mom will be like super
nice. Wait a minute, I'm not super nice to her now?
Well, you are, but it's like exceptional.
Exceptional. Yeah.
If I know that I'm in the right, which is really rare, I will just drag my feet a little bit. I get my kitchen clean. I get my bathroom clean.
That is true. When I'm upset, I clean stuff. I think early on in our relationship, you know, the first few years and stuff, we would get upset and all. I think we just learned to give each other some space, some time, and work it out and kind of agree that we'll come back together and chat about stuff, you know. We didn't let the, you know, that old deal about the sun go down in your anger kind of thing. I think we kind of took that serious. And I think it really helped. It really helped, I think.
I guess so.
Mm-hmm. I don't think you
would. No, it is.
You guess so.
No, I mean, it does.
You guys would even remember the next morning what we were mad about anyway. But
yeah.
It's good. It's good.
We don't have memories.
So my question is, and this is to each one of you, what is your favorite thing about Mom? And Mom, what is your favorite thing about Dad?
I think my favorite thing about Mom is her ability to perceive things around her. Sometimes she talks about them. Sometimes she sings about them. She'll pick a song, anything from the 60s on. And however she's feeling or observing things, that's how she communicates. So I think I stay pretty much in tune. Plus, I get up to date on the latest music that's going on.
think the my favorite thing is, especially before we got married and stuff, the thing that I really, really, and I still like to this day, is that he's a family man and that he's a really good father. I love that about him. It warms my heart every time I see him interacting with you kids. And then a close second is his sense of humor. He's so funny and I love to laugh at his fun jokes and clever jokes. I like that too.
Silly. Oh no, silly.
Mom got a close second in there, so Dad, what's your close second on Mom?
Her tenacity, maybe, to stay true to the marriage, to always be in front of what it is that we're doing. Doesn't waver, gets something in her sights, and continues down until it's complete. You're an amazing woman that way. You don't give up.
Thank you.
No, I would have given up on me a long time ago.
Like, it's got like its pluses and its minuses.
Yeah. She wants to give up, but because of that trait, it's not possible.
I might have forgotten to set the timing when I put this whole thing together. So right as I got the last head on, so I went back through the whole thing and I reset the timing in it. Now we are almost good. Unfortunately, I forgot this little air vent plate. It's gotta be there. I can't put that on with the head on. I have the head off so I can get the push rod tubes up. The head has to come off one more time. I've only done it twice. It could be worse. It's coming along though, and it looks great. These engines just look so cool. And I'm just now adjusting some valves, making sure that the valves don't overheat. They need a little bit of a gap in between the spring and the top of the rocker arm there. There needs to be a little bit of a gap. That way the valve and the rocker arm have a little bit of time to cool down. They disconnect for a second and then reconnect. If they're too big, you get that ticking or tapping sound. And if it's too small, it overheats.
Perfect.
Okay.
Looking really good, babe.
Ready to put the valve cover on. Spark plug's gotta go in. I got oil pump, we got distributor, and different caps, and the main part is all done. It is all finished up.
Are we gonna get it all put together today?
We're gonna try. I don't know if it's gonna happen or not, but we're gonna be pretty darn close, I think.
I think we're gonna get it.
The whole thing put together for real this time.
Now that the roof's up, it's time to work on the other things like the windows and doors. We have a few windows that we stored in the junkyard for a little while. Had a accident where the windows fell over and broke, but the windows that we had that was saved off for this building didn't break. Thank goodness. So we're gonna go ahead and put those up. And of course the door as well. We've had a door stored off in the brown house for a long time.
Wow.
It's fancy, isn't it?
Yeah.
I don't know why we're not installing this on the house.
It was once in the house.
Oh, it was?
Yeah.
It's gorgeous. There's gonna be no door here. Eventually we'll connect these two buildings, so there's really not a need for a door here.
So where's the door going? Over here?
Right here, yeah. Cool spot.
What is the plan?
We have this little window to stick in this big hole. We're gonna do it though.
Lots of wood around it.
Yeah. We have a window that is 23 this way and 32 and one quarter that way.
My wood is always perfectly cut. So I don't know what Dad was complaining about cutting in square or whatever, but my board, whenever I cut stuff, it's square and straight.
Shave just a touch off of that.
Totally.
Do you mind?
You're saying my cut job is not good enough?
Definitely. Definitely.
What do you think, Brian?
Wow. It's not square, but we can square it.
Now the other side in.
Cry about it, eat some lunch, get some ice cream, then come back and work, cry about it, you know, that kind of stuff. You're right, we should do one more.
The problem with having a nail gun, you tend to put way too many nails in a board.
Should we see how dead on we are?
Ah! Who said this was level? Who cut it? Oh, it's the cutters. Oh, look. You trust that one?
Yeah. Okay.
Definitely would trust that one.
Because it's on? Is that what you trust it?
Yeah, because it's on. Okay, so.
It is very scary, especially when you're on the receiving end of it.
Whose crazy idea was it to come out here, moving from the city to the country and going on this great adventure?
When we started to realize all these health benefits we were getting from the milk, you guys were allergic, you and Brian were allergic, and we were buying this goat's milk while we were in town. We just thought, gosh, you know, why don't we get our own goats? And so I started looking out to where we could actually get them, and I was looking in this area and actually a lot of different areas. I don't think your dad was really on board until he saw how I was so into it, and maybe that's the tenacity where I was just like, we just got to do this. It would be so much fun. Then dad quickly found a property, and then he found this one. I was like, oh my gosh, those broken down buildings. And you guys are running around. I'm thinking, oh my gosh. And it's just, oh, this property.
She wouldn't even get out of the van.
I was like, ugh. And dad comes back. He's like, oh, this is perfect. And I'm like, it is? And then he just kept going on and on, and I'm like, he's got good judgment, so I guess I'm just gonna, okay, it's perfect. So we got it.
It really was a perfect spot. It was just, yeah. Had all the trees and things I wanted. It was just beautiful.
Yeah, you were seeing what I was, just looking at those houses and going, oh my gosh.
I think I'd like to add, initially, mom was not doing well with some Crohn's things, you know, and stuff in her stomach, and so we were changing her diet. Practically speaking, we had goats and chickens at that little 3/4 acre house.
In town.
In town. Yeah. And I'm thinking, we need some more space. So I think in addition to what mom and I had talked about earlier too, about food and how important it was, we just needed some more space.
Team effort all the way around. So I've been painting all the green stuff. We ran out of the other can, what we were using before. So we went with a cheaper brand, and it's actually the same color, going on way nicer. What we do with the seats is like rhino-line where the fiberglass is, and hopefully that will make it not, you know, it gets all like sandpapery.
Yeah, it seems to have a good, it has a really nice coat over it.
Here we go, I'm gonna do green on top. We're getting close on the green.
We got the engine pretty much where we want it. It's ready to go in the back of the bug. Now it's time to finish off this rear axle here. We just gotta do rear brakes, and we got a whole new kit to refresh all the brakes. And so that's what we're gonna do next. And then from there, we will put it on the sand rail. We put the front end back together, and we put the transmission and the rear end back on.
Woo! All right, we got her on all fours.
Yeah.
Good. Transmission's in, we just gotta mount the engine.
We accidentally ripped the boot, which sucks, but at least it's a cheap part we broke. The brake drums are pretty stripped out, so we're probably gonna get some new brake drums for the back.
We gotta paint the shocks and put those on, stuff like that, but it's on the tires.
Woo!
Oh, cool, huh, Gary?
Yeah. Guys, this is awesome idea. I just need to raise them up a smidge. They look really good.
You wanna throw that square in that corner?
You gotta move that way.
That's good.
I just need to trim out that little section there.
Hey, look, it's a video frame. One frame at a time.
I've been framed.
I approve of that pun.
Bree approves of this pun.
We interrupt your regularly scheduled program.
Do people edge away from you during conversation? Do you cry yourself to sleep? You might have terrible puns.
We have a solution for you. Submit your comments down below. We'll let you know if it's Bree approved.
Warning, do not submit your puns if they have caused any of the following side effects. Queasiness, eye rolling, courtesy laughs, or disownment in the past. Consult your doctor if your puns get worse, you're experiencing dizziness, drowsiness, or have lost friends. We are not responsible for any groaning caused by reading the comments, or if the general experience is underwhelming. Bree's pun stamp of approval is not a standardized measurement of comedy, and audience results may vary. Batteries not included.
But I don't want my name on that. This is an efface to puns everywhere. I'm a pun advocate. I advocate for pun rights and the right to speak them in normal conversations without groans. I don't approve this message. I approve this message.
We're good. All right.
Bola gets a little upset at the gun. And Luna is holding him.
We took that wall down. This is the window that was in the kitchen.
This building is to use half of it for the hoop barn storage, and the other half I plan to put in a machine shop / tool shed area.
So what you doing up there, Shaster?
I am balancing the world.
We did the outside to make sure that we had enough in case we had to do this with a different color.
Yeah.
Looks like we're gonna have enough.
Yeah.
It's looking stupendous over here. Ship shape, I say.
Look at you, Bri. Oh. Good timing. Perfect.
Please don't paint it.
Oh, I'm sorry, I already did.
Oh, shoot.
Yeah, it's gonna be a little wet, but it's all right. Just don't touch that side. Don't lick it, preferably not. It's kind of gross.
Hi, Mom. I am helping.
Well, thank you guys. Answering our questions, we put you on the spot there. But thank you for being such wonderful parents to us. We really appreciate it. This whole adventure has allowed each one of us to grow in different ways and allowed us to explore and be exposed to things that I don't think we would have otherwise. So thank you guys for supporting us, respecting us.
Thanks for coming out with us.
Oh, yes.
Of course you were.
I don't think you had a choice.
Yeah, I think you were like 9 or 10. You guys came with us. Oh, it was awesome.
Yeah. We had a Primantis farm. Are you kidding me? This was a good farm. Yeah. I wanted to thank you for all of your support. Just this driving force through my childhood of always trying to work towards providing us opportunity to grow in our lives and to learn and not just, oh, don't do this. Oh, don't get hurt.
No, we did that. We just didn't let you see it.
Well, at least creating the illusion that... We had the opportunity to learn and still yet being in a safe environment and being loved, and it's just been amazing the lengths you guys would go to make sure that we had an opportunity we wouldn't have before. So thank you for that.
I want to thank you guys too for all the knowledge you guys gave us, because there's a lot of stuff I wouldn't know. A lot of stuff that I wouldn't know that I think any of us would really know without you guys.
Practical skills
like eating and drinking. No.
The simple stuff. Actually, we didn't know anything. We just made it up as we went along. So.
Well, it made sound sense.
Yeah.
So you did good.
Thank you for being great kids. I'll tell you that.
Thanks. We had great parents.
Oh, wait, I have one more.
I was going to say, I really appreciate, too, showing us what a good marriage looks like and being able to witness such a wonderful relationship and watching you guys argue actually was a big part of helping, because we got to see you resolve it. And that was more important than the argument, was watching that resolve and the apologies and the healing. It's been a great role model for anyone we may have in the future. I can piggyback off that too. When we argue with each other, because it happens,
it
we now know
it
how
does.
To do it. The big part of coming back together and maintaining that friendship.
Well, all three of us are yelling on the couch and we all mean the same thing, but we can't tell through lack of communication.
Oh my God, Mom and I have witnessed that.
We're like, yeah, you guys are all saying the same thing.
You know that?
I don't understand.
Not this way. I'm saying it. Clearly, I'm right.
No, I'm saying it this way.
That happened the other day.
I know it did. I was thinking about that, yeah.
We've been working on this week's video on the new Nest server. So far, so good. If you're watching this video and it's on time, then you'll know that the server worked just fantastic. And if it's a little late, we had some problems. But as we found a video on YouTube and we were able to create a Final Cut project on it. Anyway, we'll leave a link down in the description if you're interested. Final Cut is a little bit finicky working with the server, library sharing and all that. So we found that to be very helpful. Didn't notice any problems with speed. And as you can see, I can just move right through this. And I was running through and doing my ins and outs and writes, just a little bit of a hesitation. The whole project's on the NAS server. Very excited. Bryson did a great job.
You putting in a door today?
I hope so.
It's truly adorable.
He shimmies and he shakes. There's a wood putt.
Yeah, there we go. Yay!
We gotta find those anchor tie things.
Hurricane clips.
Put some shelvings and stuff in there. Metal shelving rack was donated to us.
Not many people know that these shelves are actually made for dog efficiency storage. When you start collecting a lot of dogs, you gotta start getting shelves for them.
What would you say the shelf life is for these pugs?
First test of the door.
Oh, this is beautiful.
You know, I really think that brings this project to a close.
Metal shelving system was donated to us, and it is going to be amazing. We'll be able to store all kinds of stuff in there. It is going to be so much fun to work in it. For just a square building, I figured it would just be a blocky gray building with plain windows and doors on it. I did not expect to have all kinds of different engine blocks in the walls, and it really turned out nice.
That's gonna be it for this week. We got a lot done. It's really coming together. Engine's done, tires are on, back tires are gonna take a little more, but it's in a really good place right now, looking really good.
Painted all the stuff, we just gotta put it all on. It's mostly just putting it together, which is the really fun part.
Yeah.
Well, that wraps up this week. Thank you so much for hanging out with us. The merch design of the week is pun approved. If you'd like the official stamp of approval, give all puns everywhere an official stamp of approval. I've also added a few items to our merch shop. We have another styled mug, a to-go glass, a crop top, a tote bag, a bandana. So those are some new products that have been added to our shop. If you'd like to check out this pun approved design or any of the designs that we've done in the past, you can check out that link down in the description. Thank you so much for being a part of our family, and we'll catch you next Friday. Bye.
Thank you.
Plus your questions are making me nervous.
Okay.
Dang, am I saying something?
No, I was just kidding, B-roll.
Our family moved from the city to the country. Thanks for taking part in our adventure. We have new videos every Friday evening. If you would like to help us out, you can like this video, share it, subscribe, or support us on Patreon. See the links in the description.
We are not responsible for any injuries sustained while listening to our puns.
Ow!
He sustained injury from his own puns.